The Mini Filmmaker kit is designed to produce thin films of plastic polymer materials for spectroscopy measurements quickly and easily. It consists of a mini press fitted with heated platens and a separate set of film making plates and sizing rings. It works by melting a small quantity of solid polymer material between the heated platens and then compressing the molten material to a nominal thickness determined by the chosen sizing ring. This product video will show the production of a polymer thin film from a solid bead of low-density polyethylene which has a melting point of around 116 degrees centigrade. The procedure begins by setting a temperature on the press. Before setting the temperature, ensure that the heated surfaces of the press are touching by rotating the lead screw until they meet. After the heated surface are brought together, flip the switch to turn on the temperature control. The top value is the current temperature. The bottom value is the target temperature. Set a value somewhat above the melting point of the polymer using the up and down keys on the front of the controller. In this case, we're setting 130 degrees. It will take a couple of minutes to heat up from room temperature. While the heated surfaces of the press are reaching their operating temperature, the polyethylene sample can be prepared in the filmmaking assembly. The thickness of film is controlled by the selection of sizing rings. Each sizing ring has a series of marks along one edge that indicates how thick it is, and the meaning of the marks can be inferred from the manual. The first step is to place the shield over the lower plate. Next, choose one of the four sizing rings to use in the construction for the optimum thickness of film. In this example, we're using a 25 micron thick sizing ring, identified by the five notches on its edge. Next, a small diameter foil is placed into position. The sample is placed carefully and centrally onto this small diameter foil. Now, the sample is covered using a larger diameter foil. Finally, the upper plate is brought gently into position on top of the foil. Once the temperature of the press has stabilized, the prepared filmmaker assembly is ready to be placed into the press. To insert the constructed filmmaker assembly into the press, turn the lead screw knob anti-clockwise to create a gap between the heated surfaces. On the lower heated surface, there are two small location pins that help to correctly centralize the filmmaker assembly into position. Insert the filmmaker assembly until the parts engage and touch both location pins. Turn the lead screw knob clockwise to bring the top heated surface into close contact with the filmmaker parts to begin the process of heat transfer to the polymer sample. Initially, there will be a reduction in the actual temperature display value as the cold filmmaker assembly is introduced into the hot environment. But the assembly will return to the set temperature value within a short time. When the actual and set temperature values have reached equilibrium and stability, the polymer sample within the filmmaker assembly will have melted or softened sufficiently to apply a tonnage load. Before any tonnage load is to be applied, it may be necessary to retighten the lead screw to take up any slack caused by melting of the sample. Now turn the screw on the front of the press to begin applying hydraulic pressure. An indicated load of 0.5 tons is usually sufficient to form a thin film, as shown here. The applied load is typically held for 30 seconds and then released by unwinding the pressure screw all the way back to its start position. Separate the heated surfaces further using the lead screw to aid in the removal of the filmmaker assembly. Now, very carefully remove the hot filmmaker assembly and place it onto the cooling plate. At this stage, retighten the lead screw assembly to bring the heated surfaces back together to prepare the temperature of the press for a new sample. It is possible, while the filmmaker assembly is still hot, to gently separate the components using tweezers. The film will be sandwiched between the aluminium foils placed earlier. When sufficiently cool to touch, the aluminum foils are carefully peeled away from each side of the thin polymer film. The tweezers supplied can help in the process of separation of the foils. When the aluminum foils have been removed, a thin film of approximately 15 millimeters in diameter, and of a thickness corresponding to the sizing ring, will have been produced. Specacards have been provided with the kit to mount the thin film for analysis in the spectrometer. By placing the film carefully and centrally over one of the 10 mm diameter aperture holes on the adhesive surface side of the card. The Specacard is then folded over along its central fold line to bring the two adhesive surfaces together to trap the film into position between the aperture holes. The Specacards are 3-inch by 2-inch in size and fit standard spectrometer compartment mounts. A typical infrared transmission spectrum for the polyethylene sample can be obtained as seen.